Hey everybody, Nate here from WASD20, and today I'm going to be playing Massive Chalice, which is a new game that's an early access beta from Double Fine Productions. It's been a long time since I've done a PC game, but I just figured out this open broadcasting stuff and I decided to try it out, and hey, I'm going to be playing a game anyway, might as well put it up on YouTube. If anyone enjoys it, great, but I understand these videos I do don't get as many views as my RPG stuff. It's cool by me. So yeah, this game, picked it up on the on Steam, was on sale. I kind of missed the sale though and decided I gotta get this. Actually, for my video game winterum class, my students and I are going to be interviewing Brad Muir of Double Fine, and he's one of the leads on this project. And interviewed him in the past with other classes too, so know the guy and thought, well, I should check out his game, so we're a little more informed when we interview him. So yeah, I've never played this before. I'm going to be painfully obvious, probably. Let's see, difficulties. I guess we'll go thematic. Oh, I see. Well, let's do both. Yeah, let's do both. We'll do both. Thematic and silly. Just because I want to see both.
It's taking too long.
Patience.
Patience. I don't see what patience has to do with this. It should have happened by now.
Life keeps to its own timetable, not ours.
Oh, it doesn't stop us from trying. Good morning.
Your ruler has risen. Rejoice and let bellow the horns of birth.
Right. I know how strange all of this looks, but there's an easy...
Immortal protector of the nation.
Sorry, I'm digging the art. You know, it's not super high production value here in terms of, you know, the animation and such. But the style is just cool. I do, however, I'm not a real big fan of the voice of that woman. The guy sounds proper and has like a cool accent, and the woman just sounds like some American woman. It's a little inconsistent, but whatever. It's good voice acting, I guess.
The ruler will be with you shortly.
And off they go.
We'll explain later. We just need you to take command, because our citizens, understandably, find it hard to trust a giant talking chalice.
We are not just a giant talking chalice.
But the nation will listen to you, because you're of their blood.
Forged from the bloodlines of the great houses.
Oh, and one last thing. Unfortunately, the bloodline ritual that was used to create you also bound you to us. So you can never leave the throne.
But do not despair.
How convenient.
Still command your heroes. Look inward, and you will find that your mind can follow them anywhere.
So, perfect for a strategy game. We command our heroes from the throne, right? So yeah, this is a...
Yeah? Great.
Turn-based strategy game.
And search the area.
From what I've heard, these are randomly generated maps. Okay, so we've got the controls here. Turn the camera. W is move hero. Hero info is Z. Adjust melee position is F. Okay. I'll probably have to come back to this as we go through. Keyboard a little bit. There we go. All right, let's give this a go. So, yeah, just first impression, you know, graphics aren't like great, but I just dig the art style. They're not super... Again, high fidelity graphics, super realism, but the style is cool. It's not your typical like fantasy medieval look, But it certainly is not, like, modern. Okay. So, Stephanie Patterson here. Let's move her up. Confirm. Yeah, so those people who've played this before, it's going to be painfully obvious I haven't, and I'll be struggling a bit.
They hit not so hard and just knock things out.
That's all you're going to say.
Simplest way of life there is.
Caperjacks. Profound purveyors of violence.
So, I wonder if I can move up here, or is this telling me I can't? I think I can, that's just like my, maybe my move and my action. Ooh, okay.
First catch of the day.
We can't tell you much about the cadence.
Enemy spotted.
It's old, first sighted centuries ago. It cares only for destroying our nation with its corruption.
That's where pawns like you see here come in. Think of them as attack dogs the cadence creates to spread corruption in the world.
This one is a thrower. Okay, so throwing a flask is their attack, looks like. Yeah, it looks like a, I don't know what you call it. One of those toy tosser things, the baskets or whatever, almost like that. Stephanie Patterson, it put me back to her. But what about this dude? Maybe she's only moved one of her... I should probably keep the team together here. I was thinking I was going to split, but I'm going to go all left. All left. Confirm. Alright, now we've got Grayson Callanan. Grayson Callanan. Alright. Move. There's my turn. Yeah, no idea of the strategy here. I've kind of got my crew all pretty closely clustered together. And right away, if you've ever played turn-based strategy games, this is probably a lot of familiar to you. If you haven't, you know, go check out XCOM. Enemy Unknown.
Not worth much.
Great game.
Quarters battle, but they make up for it with their nasty exploding flasks.
Just watch out for friendly fire.
The explosions are big, so aim well or keep your heroes back. Trust us, you don't want to be on the receiving end of one of their concoctions.
Okay, I wonder if I should not have moved her up with both. Should have moved her one maybe, and then moved her. Yeah, like you use one move, and then, I don't know. And I use both my moves at once, basically. Keep the team together a little better. So with these guys, just in case they attack. Okay, so yeah, these throwers can move pretty far here. Which makes sense, they're a little more lightweight. The caber dudes are, they're heavies, right? Maybe I'll put him right here. Parambuja Rude. What a name. So yeah, I think a lot of the names are kind of randomly generated too. Excuse me. And we'll see how this goes. I don't know if I want to move right next to him because I think I don't have an attack right now. So I'm going to move right here. Yeah, so people who play this game are probably screaming at their screens right now, saying, "No! Bad move!" Oh well. Alright, bring it on, enemies. What are these guys? I think they might have said that, but I was too busy talking, not listening.
That could have been worse. At least they belong to heroic bloodlines.
Oh yes, we forgot to mention. Normal humans cannot survive even a single touch from the cadence, but because the bloodlines of your heroes are attuned to us and have our power flowing through them, they have a fighting chance.
So we're gonna attack. My first attack. Oh wait, what is this? Knockback or attack? I don't know what to do. I think knockback probably doesn't do any damage. Oh yeah, low damage attack that knocks back and stuns. We're gonna try our standard attack first here. See how this goes. Confirm. Oh, 14.
How about that, eh?
One down, untold millions to go.
Nice, nice. Okay. We're gonna, oh, so yeah, there's friendly fire on these tosses. I don't know what this is going to do. Attack this target. Yeah, see, I didn't... If I had done that toss, I probably would have hurt this guy here. I don't know. Alright, so he's going to attack. And let's try the knockback just for kicks here. Oh, low damage. I think that was... Oh, wait, yeah, it was low damage. Okay, didn't kill him. So, alright. Anyway, okay, now let's try the toss here. See if I can do this. If I'm not too close. Move there, and then let's try this toss here. Throw flask. Yeah, nice, okay. So that won't hit my guys. So one of the main things in this game that I've heard, it is like a turn-based strategy game like XCOM or something like that, but it also has this whole Bloodlines thing, which if you've ever played like Rogue Legacy, it sounded kind of like that, where you have these like generations, and you, through the generations, you're like producing offspring and seeing them grow up and become heroes. So yeah, when a hero dies, they then are replaced by their offspring. Something like that. I might be right there. Maybe not. Okay, so move the screen around. I just... This. Okay, oh, nice. Yeah, you can rotate here. That's sweet. Yes. Huh. Yeah, really digging this game. Again, it's you know, not like superly graphically amazing, but the art style's cool. And I think the game was like less than a gigabyte. It'll be interesting to see how it develops, if they do go more high res sometime soon, or you know, because this is early access beta, or if they stick with this. I think they're fine to stick with this. You know, gameplay matters. From talking with Brad Muir, he's a gameplay dude. I think I have to end turn. Is that what it's asking me to do? Or do I have someone who can move yet? Yeah, just talking with him. He, you know, emphasizes gameplay over other things, and a lot of the Double Fine games don't do that. There's, you know, there's others that emphasize the humor, but yeah. Let's see here.
Your heroes are hit; they may forget some of their combat training. The mind is just as vulnerable.
And by, you know, gameplay, I mean like, innovative systems, or systems that just play really well. And yeah, okay, so this is a lapse, it's called. It looks mean. I don't think it likes me. We'll find out when I throw a flask at it. Okay, where's my other flask thrower? Flask thrower here. I don't think I can. Oh, okay, I forget. I gotta pay attention to this damage. So 74% chance of hitting and 10 to 12 damage. So this should kill it, right? If I hit, there's 74% chance of hitting. I missed. Okay, so I got that 26%. Did I do my math right there? I think I did. Attack! Knock it! Oh, two? Wonder if this thing has like higher armor class or what's going on with that. It does have a 20 under it. I don't know what that means. Oh wait, let's see what this says. Charge. Charge in a straight line for extra distance. Or to knock back target. I don't think this is gonna work here. No. So I have to, yeah, literally like diagonal there or straight ahead here, side back. Okay, so that doesn't work. Okay, so we will move. Man, these guys can't move very far. Guess we'll move there, and then I have to chill out and hang. Attack. I think I can attack from here, is this right? 85% chance. We'll see. Confirm. Nice! Whoa, 19! So, yeah, I got 2 on one of them and 19 on the next. Wow. Alright, cool. Let's see. More exploring. Okay, I'm not confident there's much over there. Let's go this way. This looks like this mist is indicative of bad guys. I should not move that far ahead yet. I need to get my, okay, so these dudes are stunned from that. Aha, I see, okay. That blast, when it died, stunned them. I don't want to move this person too far ahead here. Stephanie. Which, by the way, is my wife's name. Alright. She'd be so happy if she knew I was playing this. Putting her life at risk. Alright. Yep, we'll move you up. Move you behind this pillar. Now let's move you over to this pillar. A little risky. I'm okay with... Oh, shoot. Oh, 20 hit points. Alright. Wow, this other guy still stunned or something? I don't know. Alright, I'm gonna move here. Okay. That doesn't seem like very far. Confirm. Ooh.
Seeds. Arguably the lowliest of pawns are more nuisance than menace.
But if you're going to remember one thing, don't let those runts form a posse. Keep them apart.
Otherwise it'll be like when caber jacks get together at a tavern.
Except not the best night of your life.
Banter. Ridiculous banter. So, just want to point out like the cool fall scene here, and then you know now we're in a building. It would be interesting to see what kind of terrain they throw at us here, and what kind of environments they have, how much variety. Because I can see that adding to the game and being cool. All right, move her up. Another one. Okay. Making me nervous here, fellas. And ladies. Ah, yeah. I got them too bunched up again. This is not good. I should not be doing that. I gotta spread out a little bit more. Oh, no. 4 hit points. And the seed. Okay. So... I think I need to attack. Attack you. I'm really getting like bunched up here, but. Move there. And then. Oh, can I charge? Alright, yeah, let's try charging here. Ooh, that was nice. Cool knockback. Okay. Now, if I can move, yeah, okay. Can throw my flask. 75% chance, let's go for it. Jeez, man, on these 75% chances, I don't do so well. All right. I think I might just try a standard attack here if I can. Nice, okay, not bad, not bad. Let's attack and then we'll move here. So attack. Confirm. Definitely dead. And now can I move? Oh, maybe I can't. Maybe if I attack, my turn's over with that one. Yeah, that's the way it's looking. Huh. So, okay. Unless I already used my move before. I don't think I did. Alright. Yeah, let's move you around here. You're a caber tosser. You can take some damage. Oh, 6 hit points, though. Alright. Excuse me. Enemy is on the move. That's not good. Level lost. Wow. From taking damage, I lost a level. Oh no, this is not good. All right, let's see if we can take out this fool in one hit. Yes, easy. Oh man, 16. They can really deal some damage sometimes when they want to. All right, whose turn is this? Okay, that guy. Yeah, we're gonna toss another flask at this. Don't miss this time. There we go. Now we're talking. All right. Attack. Yeah, there we go. Oh, digging the music. Yeah. Feels kinda, I don't know. Scottish? I don't know. I don't know my musical styles. Scottish people, don't be offended. Irish? Typical American, I don't know my... I'm ignorant of other countries, maybe. Okay, can I hit that far? 66% chance. Let's take it. Toss it over there. Lob it over their heads. Watch, I'll hit my own girl. Oh, okay. Well, I didn't hit, but at least I didn't hit Stephanie. She'll be happy. I'll go tell her. All right. Whose turn we got? I'm going to move around this way. It's a little risky because there's some unseen territory there. But I don't want to bunch them up too much in case there's some splash damage or something. Glancing blow. Nothing. We got nothing. Uh-oh. That's not good. All right. Still their turn. Cold in my house. Winter. January. It was like 0 degrees today or something. 10 degrees. Alright. But under, you know, in the negatives with wind chill. People in Canada are laughing at me right now. I don't care. Yep, let's attack. Okay, can I? Oh, that's right. I maybe should have charged that guy again. This, lapse again. Oh well. Alright. Yeah. Take him out. Take him out.
Send them back to that
yes.
Sludge from whence they came.
Love that narrator there. Not a big fan of the woman. She's alright, I guess. She needs an accent or something, like I said. 90% chance. If we toss, 66% chance. Let's. 4 hit points. Let's do this one. If this hits, should kill it. There we go. Ooh, that splash damage though. I gotta remember, try to take him out with, yeah, so it probably would have been worth it to take him out with a flask. But I didn't. Alright, so now attack. Watch their eyes, it says. Oh, massive victory!
Better than I expected.
Well done, well done. I knew you'd have a knack for this.
Alright, so I think we'll play a little bit more here, just to see what's next. So we've got our clan. Oh, Momo Caddykin. I should have been paying more attention to the names. I would have taken better care of you, Momo. You can see their age here. Parambucha is a young one. Caberjacks and Alchemists. So I think there's more classes than that. But it kind of randomly generates a lot of this stuff. Their names, their class, their age. A lot of this is randomly
right.
Generated.
So this is our nation, cool. And as we said, we are not in the best of shape.
That muck you see surrounding us is the Cadence. It's what created the pawns, corrupted our lands, and is slowly tightening on us like a noose. But we do have one advantage.
Thanks to several enchanted materials that make up our body, we've been endowed with certain powers. One of them being a way to cleanse the Cadence from this world. It's really quite a miraculous process, wherein we harness the properties of...
The thing is, it takes a long time for us to charge up for this. A long time. All of the heroes you just commanded in battle will be long gone when we're finally ready.
With all that time still ahead, we need you to protect us. You'll take charge of the nation, command its citizens worthy of becoming heroes, and ensure that the Cadence does not reach the capital.
Yes, I
now
will.
Let's check out that keep you just saved.
Okay. Keep. I think I probably click on the keep now. Trying to. Empty keep. There we go.
The keeps. Bloodline forgers of the nation.
The stonemasons did good work here.
Got some new heroes here.
Here, you will appoint one hero as a regent, and one as a partner. And the more experience they have, the more they'll pass on to their children.
That goes for traits and personalities,
Aria.
Too. Everything's game.
And keep in mind, assigning heroes to keeps retires them from combat. You can't have one foot at home and one in the battlefield.
Okay. So would I want to just pick... I don't know. You know what? I like the idea of keeping Stephanie out of harm's way. Sure, what the heck? I don't know. Yeah, I'm sure.
Now that you're
my wife is not a redhead, by the way.
It's time to decide on a partner.
Although this isn't an arrangement out of love, who knows? Maybe it'll turn into that.
Oh no, I don't like this.
Personality, traits, experience, they're all important here.
Just because this is an arrangement of necessity doesn't mean you should reduce these heroes to a pile of numbers either. They deserve better than that.
Oh, look at this. So there's a lot of females here. Chance for children, none. It's gonna make me pick a male, though. Stephanie cannot be a lesbian. Not if we're going to survive. Our bloodline must remain strong. Alright. John Gallup is 15. That's just sick. So, yeah. She's not gonna marry him. Age 38. He seems like a good candidate, you know? He's 1 year younger than her. Chance for children is super high. I like it. I like it, John, or Mitchell. Mitchell Beschk. This lanky blonde man. He's sure he wants to marry her. I talked to him.
Many happy returns.
Let's give the newlyweds some privacy, eh?
Oh. Okay. So, how do I... Oh, I just close, I guess. There we go.
It's a lot to take in, but you'll handle it. Or your mind will become as cracked as our body.
You'll be fine. And welcome back.
You are here.
The massive chalice.
Right? It's a little hard to tell if you're still in your mind's eye or whatever.
This is where your heroes return to after battle. From here, you may equip them with any skills or weapons they may have earned, as well as perform research.
Basically, we can devote some of our power to help the war effort and the nation. Whether it's building new keeps, starting a Sage Rites Guild, or a Standards Crucible. Fun stuff.
Again, that lady, she's a good voice actor. Don't get me wrong. She sounds too... I don't know. Whatever. Alright, stop complaining, Nate. Play the game. Heroes. Alright, so what can I do here? Let's click on Matthew. Oh, he's sickly. Decreased maximum XP. Personality. Oh yeah, see, this is so much like Rogue Legacy with this stuff. I love it. If you've never played Rogue Legacy, I recommend it. It's a roguelike. It's got like this bloodline lineage stuff with, you know, kind of these randomly generated traits. Weaknesses, heart disease. Nimble, increased dexterity, so the strengths too, right? But decreased XP game, personalities. Yeah, this is cool. I really like this. I think I'm going to enjoy this game. I have to admit, XCOM Enemy Unknown, I loved it at first. Excuse me. But I got pretty stuck at some point where it's just like, I don't think I can beat this level. I should go back to that game too. That's a fun one. And if you haven't checked it out, I recommend it. Okay. So, I guess, this is cool, but it doesn't look like I can do anything here with them. It's just kind of check them out. And research.
Building more keeps is likely the most pressing option, as you'll be able to foster more bloodlines. But don't shun the other possibilities.
Okay.
With your approval, we can research weapons, potions, armor. The amount of time required dissuades you from researching something. Consider the Sage Rites Guild. Any hero who joins the Sage Rites will hasten the time required for any pursuit. They will never see combat again.
Keep in mind, most of our power is focused on charging up to cleanse the cadence, so we can only devote enough energy to research one thing at a time. That includes searching for new heroes. It takes a lot of effort to find people attuned with us, and it'll only get harder the more we do it. But choose whatever you want.
Well, I want to build a keep. I don't know what region. I like the look of this low, luscious... No, not that's not the right word, Nate. Lush. There we go. This lush lowland here, with rivers running through it.
Oh,
I like
it. One more thing. The end of this war is not even a glimpse on our horizon yet. But your immortality gives us an advantage. The ability
I'm immortal.
To step back and
let awesome.
Time pass.
You can start and stop this timeline at will. But we'll also stop it for you should something require your attention.
Like a cadence attack.
That is a probable possibility.
Okay, so I can pause it, the timeline. And now can I go do, like, research or something? Chalice fully charged. We're still gathering energies inside our body. 295 years. Oh, I'm sorry, you probably can't see my upper right very well on some of this stuff, but I had to put the camera somewhere. I wanted to anyway. But that says year 5, day 211 up on the upper right. And yeah, this timeline will just keep moving if I hit the play button, which you can't see behind my lovely face. Doesn't look like I can do anything, so I'll just keep playing. Sounds like bagpipes. Oh, the keep grew and it busted out of its shell.
Something without having beaten it into submission.
Should have seen my books after I was done with them.
Again, the banter's pretty good here. I can get used to the lady's voice too. No big deal. Appoint a new region. Okay, so I need a new one for this area now. I like Yeah, I don't know. Momo. It's just a cool name. Nah, I did a girl last time. Let's do a guy. Whoops. What did I do? Ah! Shoot. Regency. Okay, there we go. That's what I needed to get back to. So I need to assign someone to this keep. Matthew. Or Parumbucha. Is a female. Alright. You know, I kind of wanted a guy on one of the thrones. Call me sexist here, but I'm just trying to be equal. Grayson, my friend. Coronation, yes. Love it. Yeah, just digging the style of this game. It's cool. Alright, he needs a wife. He is 40. Yeah, we'll go with the high fertility option, I guess. She's a younger woman. But... now, I wonder... yeah, you probably have to be a little careful of the stats. What if you're... you know... I don't know. Causing certain characteristics to be carried on. I can't think of the word right now. Go ahead and type it in the comments for me. Yeah, they're sure they want to marry. Okay. Nendal, like a light in the darkness. Alright, so now what? Do I just keep on building? Is that what we do here? I get that feeling. Alright, let's go over here. This barren wasteland. Okay, so maybe I can't build a keep yet. Is that what... That's the impression I'm getting here. No, it let me build a keep there. Oh, maybe I just clicked on the middle thing. I think that's what I did. Yeah. Yeah, okay. So I don't think I can build a keep yet. Let's do some research here. I can build a Sage Rites Guild. Oh, weapons and armor. Okay. Ah. Let's do some refined alchemist armor. I don't know if that's the smartest thing to do, but we're doing it. Research, let's build another keep. I don't know if I'm quite ready to... Well, let's see what this does. The Sage Rites Guild can hasten the time required to complete research. Oh! Yeah, we should do that. I should have done that first. I should abandon my current research. There we go. That will slow the time for other things. So choose an empty region. We'll build it over here in this barren wasteland. The Rocky Valley. Alright, let's speed things along here. I think that's what I want to do. We're in year 8, day near 9, year 10, year 11. Territory attack! Yes, some action.
As you have no doubt surmised by now, it takes time for the Cadence to create its pawns. So they're only able to attack every few years. Fortunately, you cannot fight back multiple incursions at the same time.
Do you feel it? That little tingling in the air before a fight?
I feel it.
No, they do.
Here is where you can make any last-minute substitutions or preparations before you deploy your heroes to battle. Once you give the word, they'll jump in, and we'll handle the rest.
All right, Matthew.
Make sure they close their mouths when they
You're
jump.
My man. Let's see, Michelle Hong. So, we got two Caberjacks. Here's an alchemist. Let's definitely do that. Got a balance here. I don't know if I have any hunters. I haven't seen any hunters. Yeah, no hunters. It's weird. One of the things I saw, I think I watched like the giant bomb video or something like that, and I feel like I saw some hunters in that. Well, I definitely want another alchemist. And then I think we'll do the last one, another Caberjack. John Gallop. I hope none of you die! So yeah, that's cool. You can kind of switch stuff around. I'm not sure if it's going to be like XCOM in that you can actually, like, you know, take armor off one dude and put it on another. It'll be interesting to see if they let you do that. Or how much kind of individualized equipping goes on.
Hey!
What? Oh, sorry.
Now this looks a little more... Alien.
The ruptures.
What?
They rush into battle, no concern for their own safety, knowing that as soon as they come upon their prey, they'll explode into a corrosive mess of pain and suffering.
Let's throw a flask here.
Death,
hit both of these guys, maybe.
Their enemies. It's beautiful.
Disconcerting.
Yes! That was nice! Okay. I like it. Can you do the same thing? I wonder. Maybe if I move her here, she can do that. 60% chance, so not great, but we'll try it. Yes! Okay, that was awesome. Good move, Nate. I'm a genius. Alright, I think this video's gone on long enough. I don't normally like to have videos this long, but hey, if you've hung with me this long, you are amazing! And I'm gonna cut it here and call it a day. I might take a look at this again once I've played a little more, and maybe, yeah, we'll see. But hey everyone, thanks for watching. If you do want to see more of this type of thing, let me know in the comments. And yeah, make sure you like, subscribe, all that good stuff. And everybody take care. Bye-bye.